Imagine that you are working in a game. You have a mouse, a wireless mouse, and it just happens that it's been red for the last week. Then suddenly, surprise, it's not working. It needs charging. This means that you must find a charging cable, find a charging spot, and charge the mouse itself. That can be really tedious sometimes. But what if you didn't need to use the mouse in the first place? What if you just did everything on your keyboard instead? Maybe we were only led to believe that you need to have a mouse to be successful. To find out, I'm going to make in-game about it. I have 5 hours, and in these 5 hours, I will make Flappy Bird. Once I turn on my PC, I won't be able to use a mouse even for a brief second. It's been a while since I worked on a game in Unity, but the goal seems reasonable enough. Now that we have all of that out of the way, let's get started. I began by booting up Unity. Honestly, this video would have been possible even through Tab. This key basically carried this project from the beginning to the end. Unfortunately though, my setup was off, Visual Studio wasn't cooperating, and I wasn't getting any hints from it. The same goes for Google and Unity, so that's basically everything stacked against me. I even considered restarting the challenge. That's why I started panicking a bit, but then I suddenly wasn't, so that's cool. Still, after half an hour, everything was seemingly under control. One thing that helped tremendously was having a shortcut for the shortcut window itself. Creating stuff like scripts or game objects wouldn't have been possible otherwise, since they don't have any default keybinds. Because of a bug of the inspector, I found myself restarting Unity every time I changed something there. That's why I was constantly using Alt+F4. We're 1 hour in, and I have a player that can jump and a pair of pipes moving left. This creates an illusion of the player moving. It looks like you are flying to the right, but in reality the whole world is moving left. It's all the same for your eyes. This little trick is very useful for side-scrollers like this. Then I had a little problem. I couldn't use prefabs. There is no way to select them in the inspector or paste them in. I still managed to get the level generation working. Setting it up took some time. Eventually though I got it. Didn't take too long. Only 50 whole minutes. Then I gave the player collisions, and that was basically all for hour 2. Next, I added the ground and score system. There was a problem with connecting the camera to the UI. The thing is, I couldn't click on the selection box, so I had to make a script to click it for me whenever the game started. That's an interesting way to spend my time. Starting hour 4, I tried to add some visuals, and oh boy. I went to the Unity Asset Store. I was unfortunately plagued by this menacing dark mode window, which wasn't closable with the mouse. Eventually though, I managed to get the asset and it was ready to go. Not so fast. It's never that easy, is it? It wasn't actually possible to import it into the project, so I started crying internally. Then I got the sound effects. I made them in JSFXR, and they're bearable, but they're arguably still better than none. Once again, I was wondering whether it's even possible for me to finish this challenge. I didn't have a clue as to what I was doing, so I just paused the timer and went to bed. Everything was quite underwhelming, and that made me lose my motivation. It just wasn't going as planned. I didn't even have a full hour left, which only fueled my exhaustion. This meant that I had to do it fast. Next day, I started hour 5. I began by getting some grass sprite. It didn't look too bad, so I kept it, and not only because I was running out of time. That would be ridiculous. Originally, I wanted to get some random bird sprites for the player. It wouldn't have worked though, not without the animations. I just settled on using the original sprite from Flappy Bird. I wasn't able to find another PNG of the moving wings for the flaps, so it looked a bit incomplete. Now the pipes were simple enough to add. I just found the version from Flappy Bird. Same goes for the background, which I was able to implement after a bit of tinkering. Everything was working, and all I needed to do was to build a project and... Wait. Did I forget something? Ah, respawning, right. I needed a way to restart the level, and now I had to implement it. That shouldn't be too difficult. Honestly, a bit too close, but I'll take it. This is how the final build looks like. That's just a skill issue. Overall, it's not all that much. I wasn't expecting it to be as exhausting as it was. I suppose that I could have done more, or maybe not, who knows. How was it then? Terrible. Other than that, I was surprised by how much stuff you can do by only using a keyboard. Not everything though. Most of the necessary actions were possible to do, but sometimes you could just hit a complete roadblock. I mean, opening Paint or any other graphical app wasn't an option since they were all useless without the mouse. So in short, I don't want to be tormented like that ever again. See you.